Oh my goodness.
Oh well. I wish there were two of me. That way I can get twice as much work done. Well, on to illusion knitting. To do illusion knitting, it would be best if you had a Brother Standard gauge machine with the garter carriage. You could set up the punch card to do this, or better yet, if you have an electronic machine, you could do a wider pattern with that. Now, if you don't have the Brother machine with the garter carriage, then we need to manually reform the stitches to get it to work out. So here's this chart of the heart that I've used before. And the way you do it is you have to make it come out like this. You have two rows of each color, and certain stitches are going to be reformed. Now in this one here, the orange would be the orange, the blue would be the background. Every white square in this chart will be a knit stitch. The colored colored blocks will be a purl stitch. So on the second row here, there's only one stitch to reform. On the fourth row, you got quite a bit to reform. But you could reach from behind to do that, or use a garter bar to turn your work around, but then you got to turn it around again. So working from the backside is probably going to work out a lot easier with this. Now I'm going to show you an easy one so that you could get the basics of the illusion knit in on the machine and you could work your way up to these other charts. Here is a little checkerboard square. It's going to show up 1, 2, 3, 4 in when you're done knitting. And what it is consists of is every row you have to knit two rows. The first row, the white boxes are all knit. The second row, which normally in hand knit you would be turning around, the blue would be knit, but on the back side, of course, it's going to be purl. So we need to reform these blue stitches. And the blue represents one color, the purple represents the second color. So I'm using white and orange, and I probably should have had this set up as white and orange, but it was just too much going on there. Now you could also do up a chart like this. I'm not sure if you could see it, but there are white X's on the first row of each color here, and then the black X's, those are the ones I'm going to reform. Well, as you see, it's going to be these stitches here. Now, it doesn't really matter which one you're doing, but as long as you keep consistent with the chart, then everything should work out just great. Now, normally with the illusion knit-in, you're going to start out with two rows, and it's going to be garter stitch. So in hand knit, you knit both rows. On the machine, you would knit the one row. If you knit the second row, you would reform all the stitches across. Or you would take a garter bar and turn it around to knit the second row. Now, the blue is actually going to be the orange, and the orange on this is going to be the white. So when I look at my chart, the first row was knit. Now, actually, the chart represents the front of the material, so you have to think in reverse of this. So in order to make these five stitches, and that's from 0 to 5, the knit purl stitch, because these are actually going to be knit, those would be purl, these would be knit, those would be purl, all you do is you go one row down, let me get over here, you just go one row down, and as you see I did knit two rows of the orange, and then you reform the stitches according to the chart. Now this one is an easy one because it's five stitches each, and I have five stitches on each outside edge that would normally go garter stitch also in the hand knit. Now when it comes to the end needle here, the side of the carriage you can reform up. This one over here is a little bit harder because it makes a little knot. What I would do in this case is I wouldn't even touch the end needle, but I would do the next four needles and reform those. So you're going to go ahead, according to the chart, bring out what needles that are marked in black, the black X's, and reform them. After I'm done reforming, I'm going to take my first color. Now you don't want to pull up on the yarn because it will pull up on the side there. You just want the end yarn to go up normally. You may have to pull down on that orange just a little bit and then knit a second row. Now when I go back to my chart, I'm on the orange here, so I've got from right six, and I'm sorry, left six to left ten, and then right one to right five, that I will reform those. And that's going to create the purl stitches. So the blank ones, and I should have had white X's in these other boxes here. I will try to add them in there before I get it on the web page so that you could have this chart to have by you and work up your own little sample. So you just go ahead and reform whatever stitches. Now I'm not doing the end stitches here because I basically want to show you just how to get the illusion part done. And it's really that simple as to looking at a chart. When I'm done reforming, I take the first color out of the sinker plate. And I pull it way out so that it's not pulling the spring way down. I put the second yarn in, and then sometimes I have to pull the yarn through the yarn mast. But I don't make the spring really come way down. Like I said, you want that end yarn to just go up nicely. If you have it too tight, it's going to pull that up. So now, according to my chart, I have two more of these sections to do with the orange and the white. Then I go back and I reverse it so that the last three rows are going to be opposite of what I did for the first three rows, which is going to create that checkerboard. So let me finish this up and take it off the machine and show you the end and result. So here is a close-up of the finished piece, little sample, and I think you can see the purl bumps here. So I got 1, 2, 3 on the orange, 1, 2, 3 on the white. When I go in the middle here, there's 1, 2, 3 of the white, 1, 2, 3 of the orange. And there's the closeness of those two, which is the same over there as well. Now this is where the illusion comes in. When you look at it on the front, it just looks like stripes. But when you look at it from the side, you could see the checkerboards. Of course, I had to clamp those out because the sides are curling on me. And I do have my comb on there still. And I just did the extra orange on the top to separate that last row. Now, if you're going to put this on a sweater, you're going to have a lot of reforming to do. You could probably just take a little sample of an illusion knit in and put it in the center of the front of the sweater. That'll work just as well. The one thing is you do need to knit the sweater sideways. So the stripes are going to be going up and down so that when you look at it from the side, you're going to see that illusion. Of course, this one here is a real easy one, but if you were to do the heart, you're going to want to do the heart sideways.